Howdy, hey, welcome back to All About That Disney Life. I am Danny V, the girl who is all about that Disney life. We now move on to Mickey's House of Villains, which came out in 2002. So let's get to know this cast. Wayne Allwyn was Mickey Mouse. Lucy Taylor was Minnie Mouse. Bill Farmer was Goofy and Pluto. Tony Alzamo was Donald Duck, Huey, Dewey, and Louie. Chess McNeil was Daisy Duck, the Queen of Hearts, the Fates, Cy and Am, the cats. Jonathan Freeman was Jafar. Gilbert Gottfried was Iago, Corey Burton was Captain Hook and Chernabog, Suzanne Blakeslee was Cruella de Vil, Pat Carroll was Ursula, Rob Paulsen was the singing voice for Hades, Bobcat Goldthwait was Pain, Matt Fuhrer was Panic, Lois Nettleton was Maleficent, Jim Cummings was Pete the Big Bad Wolf and Ka, Scott Wagner was Aladdin, and Rod Rodney was Mike. But hold on, we have some archive footage of some old cast members who used to voice some of these characters. So we had Walt Disney as Mickey Mouse, Pinto Goldvig as Goofy, Clarence Nash as Donald Duck and Huey, Dewey, and Louie, James Woods as Hades, John Cleese as a narrator, and April Winchell as Clarabelle Cow. Now we move on to the facts all about Mickey's House of Villains. Number one, the production. This is the second movie based on the Disney Channel's TV series House of Mouse. It was produced by Walt Disney Television Animation with animation production by Toon City Animation and additional animation production by Walt Disney Feature Animation Florida. This movie was released on both VHS and DVD by Walt Disney Home Entertainment on September 3rd, 2002. So the backstory for this movie is that it's Halloween at the House of Mouse. All these villains come to the club and Jafar decides to plan along with all the other villains to take over the club and take over the House of Mouse, calling it the House of Villains. But Mickey overcomes all the villains and the club is restored to normal. Number two, the cartoons. We had a lot more cartoons in this one than in the first special, which was Mickey's Magical Christmas Snowden at the House of Mouse. So we got more cartoons with this movie. So we had Trick or Treat, which came out in 1952. Mickey's Mechanical House, which came out in 1999. How to Haunt a House, which came out in 1999. Lonesome Ghosts, which came out in 1937. Dance of the Goofies, which came out in 1999. Donald Duck and the Gorilla, which came out in 1944. Donald's Halloween Scare, which came out in 2000. And Hansel and Gretel, which came out in 1999. And in addition, certain pieces of animation in the House of Mouse segments are recycled from the series episodes Halloween with Hades and House Ghosts. So let's give some background stories with each of these cartoons. So we had Trick or Treat, the first cartoon. It is a 1952 animated short film produced by Walt Disney Productions and released by RKO Radio Pictures. The cartoon, which takes place on Halloween night, follows a series of pranks between Donald Duck and his nephews with Witch Hazel. The film was directed by Jack Hanna and features the voices of Clarence Nash as Donald and his nephews and June Foray as Hazel. The film introduced the song Trick or Treat for Halloween, which was written by Mark David, Al Hoffman, and Jerry Livingston, and performed by the Mellow Men. The next cartoon is Mickey's Mechanical House. This cartoon is narrated in rhyme. Mickey Mouse keeps trying to sleep while living in an old, unrepaired house, which constantly annoys him. Mickey decides to move out of it. He takes Pluto and runs down a sidewalk full of houses. Soon he meets a salesman who is selling a modern and clean electric house, where anything can be controlled by a push of a button on a remote control. Mickey, delighted that it was better than the others, buys the house and moves in it. At first, the mouse is happy with his new home, but his robotic servant and malfunctioning equipment make him change his mind and escape from the place. Eventually, Mickey changes his values and returns to live in his old house. The next cartoon is How to Haunt a House. This is based on the old school Goofy how-tos, which I'm so glad that they included these in the House of Mouse because watching Goofy how to learn to do something is always funny. In order to demonstrate how to haunt a house, the narrator arranges for Goofy to temporarily be not living and selects Donald Duck to be the one whom Goofy's ghost will have to haunt. The next cartoon is The Lonesome Ghosts. Mickey, Donald, and Goofy are hired by telephone to drive out four ghosts from a haunted house that has been long abandoned. Unbeknownst to them, however, they were called by the ghosts themselves, who who are bored because nobody has visited the house for a long time. They wish to play tricks on the living and do so through a series of inventive, annoying pranks. The next cartoon is Dance of the Goofies. As they do every night, the Goofy Fairies come out to close all the flowers. When the goofiest Goofy Fairy causes his boss to be captured by a young boy with mad scientist ambitions, he must overcome his goofy shortcomings and come to the rescue before his boss becomes a science project. The next cartoon is Donald Duck and the Gorilla. On a stormy night, Donald and his nephews overhear a radio announcement. Breckenridge notified the listeners that a gorilla named Ajax has escaped from the city zoo. As a prank, Donald frightens his nephews with gorilla hands, vowing revenge, and you know what that means when it comes to these nephews. They dress up in a gorilla suit and sneak up behind Donald as he reads, taking a bite of Donald's lollipop. Donald, comparing the bite to the gorilla's fangs, runs away in fright. The next cartoon is Donald's Halloween Scare. Donald scares the candy out of Huey, Dewey, and Louie's trick-or-treat bags, so naturally they have to retaliate. And by retaliate, I mean they pretend to be zombies and rise up from the grave. Blech. Is retaliation and terrifying. And then the last cartoon is Hansel and Gretel. Mickey and Minnie play the roles of Hansel and Gretel in a musical retelling of the fairy tale. Number three, bonus facts. Despite appearing on the DVD's covers, backside, and in the short Mickey's Mechanical House, Pluto does not make an appearance in this movie. Also, despite being used in the movie's promotional trailers, Mr. Smee only appears for a split second in the final movie. Rob Paulsen provides the singing voice of Hades during its Our House Now, making this the first Disney production where the character is voiced by someone other than James Woods. Some of the scenes from the beginning of the movie, such as Mickey's introduction, were reused in House Ghosts. The scene where Donald tries to scare the beast but gets scared by him was reused in Halloween with Hades, along with the scene where he said that he will never scare anyone. When Mickey was about to battle Jafar in his wizard attire, there is a direct reference to the dinosaur section of Rite of Spring from the original Fantasia. When Mickey appears on stage and all the villains gradually turn their heads towards him, it's very similar to when the Tyrannosaurus Rex appears and all the other dinosaurs face him. Jafar's defeat at the end is similar to that of Aladdin, where he gets sucked back into the lamp. Some of the characters involved in the takeover of the house aren't actually villains at all, like TikTok Croc, Witch Hazel, and the Haunted Mansion ghosts. Iago was also a villain, but reformed before this movie in The Return of Jafar. Also, Anastasia Tremaine is another reformed villain, but she is shown as a villain in this movie. That's because Cinderella 3 was released 5 years after this movie, and so she was still a villain at the time. Jafar was the only villain from Aladdin. Razul and his guards don't appear in this movie, but in fact, they would oppose Jafar. And if you cut out the cartoon shorts from this movie would only be 10 minutes long. And there you have it, all the facts to Mickey's House of Villains. If you like this video, please hit that like button and don't forget to subscribe. And I hope you have a zippity-doo-dah day. Goodbye.